Would you believe me if I tell you something that can change your entire life if you do it for like just 5 seconds every day? No, right? It was unbelievable for me as well. But as I read through Mel Robbins' 5 seconds rule, I'm pretty convinced that this thing, which I'll be sharing in some time from now, actually works. People across the world have been using this rule to do so many things, from getting up early in the morning to even saving oneself from contemplating suicide. Now, if you want to know that one key that can help you achieve literally anything and everything in life, then keep on watching. Hey guys, I'm Jessica and welcome or welcome back to my channel. Before coming to the rule part, I'll be sharing with you a lot of stuff, like why this rule works, how and when can you apply it. But if you're only interested to know what it is, then you can skip this video according to the timestamps given in my description box. And you can also check out the link to get this book from my description box. We all have been guilty of not doing things which we know we should be doing. Be it something as small as raising hand in class or taking part in a discussion, to something big as making major shift in career choices. And between these two things is a huge spectrum of must-do things, which includes a variety of things. But there's one thing that's common to all these things. If you study carefully human behavior when they are to try something new or something that requires courage, then the first thing that comes to them right after the thought of doing something is hesitation. And that moment of hesitation is a killer. Now, there's a major, major belief among people that in order to improve or do our best, we must feel motivated. But according to Mel, forget motivation. It's a myth. I don't know when we all bought into the idea that in order to change, you must feel eager or feel motivated to act. It's complete garbage. The moment it's time to assert yourself, you will not feel motivated. In fact, you won't feel like doing anything at all. If you want to improve your life, you'll need to get off your rear end and kick your own butt. In my world, I call that the power of a push. Now, I like to agree on this because whenever we come across a thought to try something new, immediately after that creeps in hesitation. And the reason is very simple. That is, our mind tricks us into not doing things by thinking them through. In simple words, the more we think about doing things, the less likely we are to do them. Now, to overcome that, it is suggested that we must do a thing as soon as we get the idea of it and if it feels right to us. Now, this point is very important because this rule is only applicable to those things which we feel are right, but somehow we don't have the courage to do them. Mel says, I've built real confidence by learning how to honor my instincts with action so that they come to life in the real world. I use the word honor on purpose. That's what you're doing when you use the rule. You're honoring yourself. You're championing your ideas. And each time you use it, you take one step closer to being the person you are truly meant to be. Your instincts may seem stupid in the moment, but when you honor them with deliberate action, it can change your life. Now, while talking about acting on your instincts, trusting your gut is a phrase which we all are familiar with. But there's so much more than just that. A research from University of Arizona in partnership with Cornell and Duke has shown that there's a powerful connection between our brain and our instincts to act. Like when you set a goal, your brain opens up a task list. And whenever you are near things that can help you achieve those goals, your brain fires up your instincts to signal to get those goals completed. Let me give an example. So let's say you have a goal to get healthy, okay? Now, if you walk into a living room, nothing happens. If you walk past a gym, however, your prefrontal cortex lights up because you're near something which is related to getting healthier. Your prefrontal cortex, which is right here, is the part of your brain which you use when you focus, change, or take deliberate actions. So as you pass the gym, you feel like you should work out because that's your instinct reminding you of your goal. And that's your inner wisdom, and it's very important to pay attention to it no matter how small or how silly that instinct may seem. So now we understand the importance of doing things which we feel are right, but somehow we don't have the courage to do them because our mind stops us by delaying to do them. And this is how the system of our brain works. The longer we think about something, the lower our urge to act becomes. Because as soon as that impulse to act kicks in, we start rationalizing it away. So that's why we've got to move faster so we can break free from our own excuses before our minds can trap us. Now, this is where this rule will help you to move faster towards your action. Now, this may not necessarily be 5 seconds for everyone. You need to observe when exactly those negative thoughts approach you, and it is usually 5 seconds, but it could be lesser for some people. So now what you need to do is, the moment you have an instinct to act on a goal, you must count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and physically move, or else your brain will stop you. Something as simple as that has helped people across the world in ways more than one can think of. So try this for yourself and let me know in the comment section how this rule has helped you. Also, make sure you subscribe, like and share this video. And if you found this video interesting, you can check out my playlist right here for more such videos. I'll see you guys probably next week. Till then, stay safe and take care.